We've been in a long-term drought. The reservoirs have gotten practically drained, and the El Nino weather pattern that we're currently experiencing out in California has been a blessing for us. It's great to see California greening up, but not all of the reservoirs have completely caught up. So we're having to be careful in how much water we pull out of those rivers. I was recently out in California, and I saw the Sacramento River. It was great to see that much water in the river, but you know, frankly, a lot of the reservoirs had been drawn down to very serious levels in the last few years. And also the environment had taken such a huge hit that many of the species are barely hanging on. A lot of people are frustrated with how much of that water we're able to actually divert and put to use. So this single year has not yet gotten us out of the woods. We may still fill many of our reservoirs, and that's great, and it'll help in terms of allocations, but a lot of the drought impacts will be ongoing. The groundwater levels in particular will take additional time to recharge. In some instances, groundwater where there's been subsidence, that's never going to be rectified. Droughts are cyclic in nature. So even if we've got the good fortune that we're getting out of a drought in California right now, it will be back. The drought will be back either in California or somewhere else at some point. So it behooves us as water managers to create drought contingency plans such that the next time that we face a drought, we have a better understanding of the actions that we need to take to really minimize the adverse impacts on us.